Hello, everybody. I'm going to be demonstrating how to cast on. And I've taught different verses for this for some of you. So I'm going to be doing a couple of different verses to teach this, but it's going to be the exact same casting on stitch. Now, of course, when we cast on, we're going to begin with a slip knot. And some of you might not remember how to do a slip knot. So to do a slip knot, when we're knitting, we want to leave a tail that is long enough to hold all the stitches that we're going to cast on. I'm going to be casting on 15 stitches. So let's see, I think I will leave a tail about this long. So to begin this, you might have your own way of tying a slip knot, and that is fine. I'm going to teach you a way that I like to do sometimes, and you can follow along with me if you need a reminder. I'm right-handed, so I'll be holding the string in my left hand. If you are left-handed, you could start with this in your right hand. But I'm going to hold the string in my left hand, and you'll notice that my hand is on top of the string. And the string is hanging down in a little loop that looks like a swing. And it's important that my hand is on top. Now my right hand fingers, my two pinchers, are going to slip into that swing, and they're going to make a triangle. My two left hand pinchers are going to slip into the swing and make a square. Now I can rotate the triangle end, pick up the string, and pull it through, and there is my slip knot. So to cast on, we take that slip knot and we put it on one of our knitting needles, and we can tighten it up a little bit. So when you put your slip knot on your needle, you can tighten it up a little bit, but it should still be able to move, so you don't want it too tight. Now, again, I'm right-handed. I'll hold this in my right hand, and I'm going to use first the Tompton verse, which I've taught to some of you. So remember in the Tompton story, Father Tompton comes. So Father Tompton's coming with my left hand here, and he's going to grab hold of the branches, and he's going to open wide the fox's den. And I can look right down into the fox's den. I see a little triangle there, right down in the fox's den. And then the Father Tompton is going to lower the stick way down. Remember to get your elbow down too. You want to get it way down under the root, over the dome, pick up a Tompton and bring him home. And then wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. You can see the Tompton clinging on there. Now here it comes again. Father Tompton grabs hold of the branches and opens up the fox's den. And really take a moment to look inside that fox's den. You should see a triangle. And then Father Tompton lowers the stick way down, and now I see a V here. And he's going to go under the root, over the dome, pick up a Tompton, and bring him home. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. There he is clinging on. Now, if you get comfortable with this, you'll notice that I can do this without having to stop and open up the fox's den every time. You can keep going. But if you ever find that you get stuck, then you can always let go for a minute, remind yourself the first step is opening wide the fox's den. So grab a hold of the branches and open it wide, and then Father Tompton is ready to lower his stick under the root, over the dome, pick up a Tompton, and bring him home. Wiggle, wiggle. Now some of you have learned a different verse to learn this skill. It's the exact same kind of casting on, but you've heard me tell it a little bit differently. So another thing I like to say is, again, holding the string, the needle with the casting on in my right hand, and my left hand, I've got the bird. This is the mama bird, and here's my beak, and here's my wing. So here's how we do the same casting on with this verse. With my wing I hold, with my beak I'm flying through. Open wide, mother bird swoops down low. Under branch one, over branch two, pick up a worm and fly back through. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. So again, here's my beak and my wing. With my wing I hold, with my beak I'm flying through. Open wide, mother bird swoops down low, under branch one, over branch two, pick up a worm and fly back through. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. And you'll keep doing this until you have your 15 stitches. or however many stitches you're going to be casting on.